The main page of the basic view in DealBook 360 shows us a chart, the news information, open positions or active trades we're currently in, working orders, and a quote board. Everything you see on the screen is fully customizable to your liking and is similar to a Windows-based environment. With a simple right-click and release on anything within the screen, you can open a window of options, then left-click to select. Within each of these windows of the main page workspace, you'll notice four icons in the top right-hand corner of the screen. A roll-up feature, minimize, maximize, and an X to close the screen. When you select these options, please note that if you select the X to close the window, it will be deleted from the screen. You can also add workspaces at the top of DealBook by right-clicking on any one of the existing workspace titles, like Main Page, and choosing Add Workspace. You can give it a new name, and you'll start with a blank screen. When you start with a blank screen, you can right-click on an empty space and choose from anything within this list to add to your new workspace. For instance, you can add a quote board, access a chart, utilize a dashboard, or add anything else from this list. For this exercise, let's select chart. Now you can select which instrument you'd like to trade and arrange the windows accordingly. It is up to you as a user to determine what your workspace will look like. As you grow in your trading experience, your workspace may change accordingly. Many newer traders start out by using this basic view without changing it or utilizing our web-based trading platform, DealBook Web. Starting with the chart, maximize the screen in the top right-hand corner so you can see the chart in a larger view. To change the type of chart and the time scale, select from the drop-down menus in the upper left-hand corner of the chart. Prices are listed on the right-hand side of the chart, and the time aspect is listed on the bottom axis. One way to place a trade is directly from the chart. You can right-click and choose to buy, sell, or one of the other various advanced orders available. In this instance, let's go ahead and sell at the current market price. You will see a direct deal ticket appear. Choose the number of lots that you would like to trade and select submit. Immediately, you'll hear a sound and see your trade appear in the chart with a dashed line. You'll also see a label attached to that line that will show you details about that trade. To the left of the chart, there are drawing tools. There are many drawing tools to help you, including a price alarm, a value calculator, trend line tools, Fibonacci tools, and many others. You can change the instrument shown by selecting the symbol to the right of the time scale. You can also compare two instruments to one another by selecting the secondary symbol. It will then place a second instrument right on top of your chart, and its pricing will be displayed to the left of the screen. To remove the secondary signal, click on the select symbol again and choose none. This icon is also used for Foresight AI, one of our paid subscription services. Right-clicking on the chart not only allows you to place trades in the market, but it provides you with a menu of options beyond trading. To name a few of these options, you can go into chart properties to change the way your chart looks in a variety of ways, including the fonts, colors, or time zones. You can also add indicators to your chart by right-clicking within it. Select Add Studies from the menu to access the list of indicators available. You can choose from any one of over 85 indicators that DealBook 360 has to offer. Let's choose Bollinger Bands for this exercise. You can change the parameters if you like, and it will immediately show up on the chart. To remove the indicator, left-click on it and press the Delete key. Or you can right-click on the indicator and choose Remove Bollinger Bands. To access other tools within this workspace, you can minimize the chart by locating the second row in the top right-hand corner of your DealBook screen and selecting the middle symbol. It looks like a box with a shadow around it. This will place the chart back in its original location. The news information is listed to the right of the chart. Within the news, you can see latest news information coming through from a variety of news services, including Informa Global Markets and Thomson Reuters News Service. Your news headings also appear at the top of your screen, where you will see a gray bar that will flash every time a new news announcement occurs. Simply double-click on that gray bar to read the body of the news heading. In the bottom right-hand corner of this workspace, you will see an open positions window. This is where you will see the trade for the instrument we sold earlier. We'll notice our profit or losses listed here as well. We can see here prices are moving in real time. To close your trade, you can right-click on the chart and choose the opposite position to close it out. Since we are in a sell trade in this situation, placing a buy will exit that trade. Or you could go back to the open positions window and choose close at market when you right-click on the line of information available for that currency pair. Confirm the order, and the line will disappear from the chart and the open positions window. Working orders holds the orders that are waiting to be executed, whether that is due to extreme movement in the market or if you have any stop or limit orders that are waiting to be executed. To show stop and limit orders, let's place another trade. To do so, we'll maximize the chart. Right-click on the chart and choose PNC buy or PNC sell. Choose submit and select yes to submit the order. You will hear the sound that your order has been placed, and you will see that the trade is active. You'll notice that we're in a buy position, so we want the market to move up. If the price moves up in our favor, we'll take profit at the line at the top, which is our limit order. You can adjust your stop and limit directly from the chart by simply placing your cursor on one of the two red lines to click and drag. In this example, let's move the limit up. Your cursor will turn into a hand as you move it over the red line. Left click and hold, you'll see the hand hold a fist, drag it upward, and release to the designated area. You will need to do this quickly since the market moves in real time and the order will reset upon every market move. Select yes to accept the order and you will see it move. Now let's move our stop down. Left click and hold, drag it downward. Release, select yes, and it moves to the new designated price. Now let's minimize the chart. You will see within the working orders, we have two sell positions listed. These are working orders, meaning that they are orders waiting to be executed. When the price reaches either one of these two points, it will close the trade out and cancel the two working orders. You will either take profit or loss at that point. If you want to close this early, you would go to the working order screen, right-click on either of the two contingent orders, choose cancel, replace to market, and you will see all three lines disappear. The open positions are now gone, and so are the working orders. The quote board is also customizable. It's located in the bottom left-hand corner of the main page workspace. Right-click on the quote board, and you can filter or configure it however you wish. Currently, it displays the top 50 currency pairs in alphabetical order. To filter the quote board, right-click anywhere within it and choose Filter. Then you would highlight the first currency pair and hit Ctrl-A on your keyboard. You'll notice that all of the instruments are now highlighted. Select one of the X's so that it deselects the checkbox. Left-click one time on any of the currencies listed, and then you'll be able to freely select which instruments you'd like to include in your quote board. You can customize it to whatever instruments you choose. You can see now it only has the instruments we've selected. You'll also notice within the quote board, you have the ability to trade. You can double click on any one of the bid or ask prices of the currencies and it will open a new order ticket. You can also monitor daily pricing, the highs, the lows, the opens, the closes, and many more. So there's a lot of data available to you in the quote board. At the top of the screen, you'll see File. You will have the option for different layouts. Configure parameters to change some of your default settings or account details. The View area allows you to open any of the items as windows in the workspace. If you would like to place a new order, you can go to Trades, which is just to the right of View. Or you can choose the New Order button displayed on the screen. Placing trades can also be done through dashboards. If you select Dashboard, they look like little deal tickets. This is also customizable by right-clicking and choosing Add to Dashboard. Here you can choose which items you would like to add. You'll also see statements for reports on your account details and analytics pages, which contain subscription services, news and commentary, and an economic calendar is also available. Under Window, you can choose to vertically or horizontally tile any of the floating windows within the workspace. This will display all the windows evenly spaced within the workspace. Your financial information includes your margin requirement or the amount that is needed to support any trade that you're in. Cash is the amount that is available for you to withdraw. Unrealized P&L is your unrealized profit or loss that is waiting to settle. In other words, it is trades that have completed that are not yet settled. Total equity is the amount that you have in your account, including unrealized P&L. Floating P&L is profit or loss currently in your trades. And finally, available equity is the amount of equity you can currently trade with. This is also customizable. You could right-click and choose which items you would like to view. You may notice an arrow to the left and right just in between the items. You can scroll through by left-clicking and holding to move your windows freely. This concludes our demonstration of DealBook 360. If you have any additional questions, please contact us 24/7 on live text chat or at www.gftforex.com/contact. Thank you.